Right, who wants one?
It is good for our children to see that there's a different side to life as well. We hear about it, we tell them about it, but actually seeing it firsthand, I think, is certainly more powerful.
Sharon Gumpo is hoping the experience will help to move their lives in a different direction.
I want to do this because I think it will be a great motivator to the girls. It will help them realise that there is a better life beyond what they're living now.
Many people sponsor children living overseas, but with 4 million living in poverty in the UK, the Brotherstons have decided to support a family closer to home.
OK, here's the family we're going to be sponsoring.
My biggest worry is I look at the family and think, well, if you really wanted to, you could get yourself out of that situation, is my biggest worry, and to sort of, you know, judge them that way.
My name is Yolanda. I'm 10 years old and I live in London with my mum and my two sisters.
We've lived here for over a year now. It's scary.
This is my room. All these books are all mine.
I didn't borrow them from school.
Moesha's bed is low because
the bottom part, the base, had to be thrown away because it was broken. We hope you enjoyed watching All About Us. Lots and lots of love from the Gumpos.
Bye.
I think I could actually quite easily be someone friends with that, because I could see that she wasn't going to be horrible. She seemed really nice.
I think they're just like normal family in abnormal circumstances.
Seeing how they are kind of making the most of what they've got, it is kind of quite inspiring. So I think, you know, my kind of, in a very strong sense, is, well, what can we do to help them?
Although the Brotherstons give to charity, they've never done it on such a personal level.
I'm trying to put myself in their position. I'm a bit concerned that they'll think, well, who do you think you are, sort of coming along, offering support and help? I don't know how I'd feel about that if it was the other way around, actually.
Dear Gumpos, I love the DVD you sent us. I would love to meet up with you sometime as you seem really nice.
I live in the countryside near Brighton. I have quite a lot of computer stuff like iPods. I do dance, drama, piano and guitar. Hope to see you soon. Lots of love. Grace.
Dear Sharon, we enjoyed hearing a little about you and seeing what lovely girls you have. You must be very proud. We know that it is not always possible for you to treat the girls to lots of things, but it was lovely to see them make the most of what they have and be so positive. We have enclosed another envelope. This is the first part of a contribution we would like to make to help improve the quality of your lives together. Kind regards, Christine and Ken Brotherston. £2,000. I guess it will take time to sink. They don't know how much this means to us. I have no idea. To think that someone can actually just give it to you. I haven't met these people. I haven't worked for them. It's very touching to know that there are people out there who are genuinely caring.
I feel shocked and happy at the same time.
A lifeline has been thrown to my family.
Dear Grace, it is a pleasure to be finally writing to you. I've read all the things that you like to do on the letter that you sent me, and I found it interesting. Now I would like to tell you my interest.
The kind of school I go to is a very international school.
Good morning, Sasid. He's here. Good morning, Walid. Good morning, Yolanda.
Good morning, Miss Gray. Thank you.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
When I go to school, you can have free dinners because some parents can't afford it, so then me and Louisa got free dinners.
How do you like 1,007 hospitality
mindsets? I think a school like my school get a better education than a private school because there they'll normally have things like jacuzzis, baseball, swimming pools, and if you had to make a choice, I think they'd probably go for the fun stuff than the education.
Yolanda, I go to a public school. It's a very good school. It's one of the best schools in England. Obviously, you get the basic education like maths, English, science. This school probably has a lot more opportunities, like lots of drama and dance and music. But state school might just have maybe the odd sport here and there. I think that the people who leave state school might get something like a shopkeeper or work at a bar. So I think if you start poor and don't get a good education from the end, unless you find some loophole, that's where you're going to end up.
It's been a few weeks since the Brotherstons sent a cheque to the Gumpos.
I think we've acted in perfectly good faith in seeing a family that looked like a decent, deserving family. My worst scenario would be, they all go off to Torre Molinos for a week or they put it on the 2:30 at Kempton. that would be sort of slightly hilarious. But, I mean, having seen the family on video, I'd be stunned if they were sort of reckless with it.
Dear Christine and Ken, thank you very much from the bottom of our hearts. I'm just looking for these school dresses. I'm sure that's the correct colour. With the money you sent us, we got some school dresses which are cooler in summer and help them to fit in.
I like it.
They also picked out pretty pink outfits and shoes. I've also paid up my gas and electricity bill at a time when we were almost being cut off. 1560. I've been out shopping. You want to see what I was shopping?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll have to go upstairs and see.
Look!
Oh my goodness!
I want to sleep on the top one.
I'm jealous.
Oh my goodness!
Cool! Oh my god! This is more better than bunk beds.
Oh my gosh! This is such a sick bed.
Okay.
Although Sharon's been able to take care of the immediate needs of her kids, she's still stuck in a cycle of debt.
I have a mountain of bills. Going to bed at night and waking up in the morning.
All I think about are bills, debts, notice of arrears, final demands, etc. It has been extremely upsetting and has, at some point, killed my confidence. Well, from the letter, certainly, it sounds like the debts are quite significant, which are obviously a problem in themselves, but I think can also just seem utterly overwhelming.
There's a part where she says, I do feel upset about not being able to provide for my kids in the manner in which I would like. And, I think for any parent, that must be incredibly, incredibly difficult.
Dear Grace, today we're breaking up for Easter, and so far my plans are nothing.
Get
my sleep! Stop laughing at me!
It's a good question.
I'm asking you, there's more space up the
drink. I don't like being on school holidays. At home, there's nothing to do, so I think it's quite boring.
No! I'm just
We've got to do something.
My mom thinks it's too dangerous for us to go out alone, and she's a bit tired, so we can't go.
I think it is important that when you're a kid, you go and play outside, because when you're a kid, you've got to keep yourself active, not just stuck at home doing nothing.
Most of my friends do have parties and sleepovers, and I do get invited, but then I can't go.